don't know much about the French I took, but I do know that I love you. And I know that if you love me too, what a wonderful world this would be.
Hello, ladies. Welcome to Linda's Stamping Escape and our Technique Tuesday. How is everybody today? Hope you're doing well. All right. Hi, Barb. How are you today? I hope we can get this little bugger to work tonight.
So.
All right. I am truly excited about tonight. I've got a great demo planned. So, I am truly excited. I know it is another pansy patch, but, you know, don't you want to see as many things as you can with this? That's how I look at it. So, anyhow, amazing. I think this is the first time you're going to see this technique used with this bundle. Barb's doing well. Good. Hi, Nicole. So, I would say about 10 or 11 years ago, we did a technique creating pansies with a butterfly punch. So, I don't know. You can't get the whole thing in there, but that is a scrapbook page I made of my mom. And there is the little pansies. And we did those with the butterfly punch. So, I have been looking up pansies all over the internet and I found some really cool ones. And between that and these flowers, it just inspired me to create what we're going to see tonight. So I am excited. And what you are going to need is shimmery white cardstock. This works way better than your regular cardstock because it holds up better to the water. I have to do my page here. Whoops. There we go. Hopefully that helps. All right. And so here it is. I don't know if you can actually see the little shimmer in there. It's not real pronounced, but there is a little. So when you use it with your watercoloring effect, you will see a little bit of that through that as well. So, all right. Okay, hopefully I can keep up with my comments here. So I'm using the stamp set just basically for the greeting tonight. So we'll tuck that aside. This is going to be our prize for all our commenters last week. So when we do our drawing at the end, I found some more of that lovely glitter. All right, ladies, what is this? Washi tape. So silver glitter washi tape. That is what I'm going to give away tonight. So I'm just going to leave that there so I don't forget. We're going to set the pansy patch aside. And then these are the three dies that I use to cut out my little pieces. So here they are. And I'm about ready to crack up because I got all this stuff prepared and supper done and dishes done. And I forgot my paper. So let me... All I need is something to absorb with. So, you would use paper towel. But since mine is way upstairs, I'm just going to use one of my cleaning towels. So that works too, right? So those are pieces there. I got a little block over here. You can see part of it. I'll pull that a little bit closer. I'm actually going to have water on there, just in case I need a little extra. So just put a little dab in there. And I have one of the old blender pens. They also have water painters. And those are on page 129, and you'll find that with the spritzers. You're going to need the spritzer for getting your pieces wet. And I don't do them all at once. That's just too much. So we're going to do this. All right. We need ink. So let's put our ink right here so you can see. And we are going to use Blackberry Bliss. We'll put that right there. That's probably more than you're going to need. Daffodil Delight. And the Old Olive. What's nice about watercoloring your pansies is you're not restricted to a designer paper. Not that that restricts me, actually. I kind of like that because it gives me a good boost on what colors I can use. You know, some days you just don't think as well as you should. Okay. And then I have, you can tell I was using green with that one. Didn't clean that one off. Wow, I'm not very good at cleaning my brushes, am I? All right. Well, this one I am going to clean off. There we go. And this one. And that's why I wear black pants all the time. Now they're clean. And I will just leave this one for my green. Okay. Again, you can use this if you wish. So let's begin. Again, you have to start with the shimmery white cardstock. And then I use those three dies that I showed you. There's our pansy die. And there's one of the pansy petals. So that goes behind there. And then I picked out the leaf as well. So those are what we're going to be working with tonight. All right. How do you like that? I draw a little arrow on the top of my spritzer so I don't spritz myself. Trust me, it's been done. You want to saturate your pansy. All right. And you'll see that sometimes the water wants to go out of there. All right. Now I'm going to take just a little bit here. And what I'm going to do is just start, look at that. And like I said, this is my cleaning towel, so I really don't care if it gets ink on it. So nature creates beautiful patterns, and they're never the same. It's kind of like a snowflake. So when you see this, it's just gorgeous. We're just going to move that right there. And you can go back in and you can darken parts of this up if you want. Some of that's going to leak off because he keeps moving. That's why I said if you want to go back in and darken a few spots, you can do that. There we go. And while I have that water on there, I'm just going to put a dot right there. Sometimes he'll spread, sometimes not, because I kind of waited a while to put that one on there. So we'll do it more when we do these. All right. I'm going to do two of these at a time. You could probably do three, but get them juicy. want to sit nice on this. There we go. Look at that. Ooh. Now let's come in and do the yellow. That's weird because it just pushed all that all the water down. So let's take our little aqua painter that has a wet tip, and let's just add some more water there. There we go. This is such a fun and experimental. You can play with this, see how much water you want or don't want on there. Mine keeps dripping all off to the bottom here. So I'm going to take that aqua painter and pull in some of the yellow here. There we go. And that's not working very well. So let's just pull a little color down in there. So what are you thinking so far? Little messy, yes, but wait till you see what we all do with this. A little more color in there. Now, just use your imagination. Let it go wild, because you can actually, pansies are in so many different colors. They are pinks and blues and yellows and so many different colors out there that, you know, it's just amazing. All right, I see I finally got color up on the top. So let's get that yellow up there quick. There it goes. And now I'm going to pull this down. That one's got a lot of water on it. We're just going to tip this a little bit, get some of that excess off, get a little more ink on there. There we go. Because it can go wherever you want it to go. You can help guide it, especially these, because they have, can you see how this one has creeped up there now? And these are the little veins that are already in the dye. So it not only cuts it, it scores for you too. So we're adding a little more darkness down here. Get it nice and dark. Same with this one. And again, you can experiment. If you like it light, leave it light. I saw some very pretty, very pale blue pansies. Like I said, I've been having a whole lot of fun on the internet searching and searching. Okay, so now we have those done. So I'm just going to clean off my brushes over there. Get a little water. Oh, I'm making a mess. You didn't know you could use your blocks for all this fun stuff, did you? All right, and not to worry, like I said, this is just my cleaning towel, so I'm going to set those up there, and then we'll move them a little later so they get to dry for us. And then we're going to grab our leaves. Not put them too close there, because we don't want that. Can you see them down there? Oh, not really. All right, let's move this then. Let's move this up so you can see the leaves better. There we go. Get that spritzer back out. Nice and green. Watch him go. Ooh. This one's fun because he just is already pulling up on the in those little veins. And then I'm
just going to pull this color out here and get some dark edging. Gives you that beautiful soft watercolor look. Doesn't take a lot. As you can see, I'm just kind of touching with the brushes. You'll get more water control if you use the water painters. So that is up to you. We don't want that. Oh well, it's nature, right? Does what it wants. All right, let's do that. Let me get some more in here. There we go. Get those edges. And bring that color out. Okay. So all this started when I saw that picture of my mom and those beautiful pansies, and I thought, why can't I try this with the die cuts? So that's where that all started. That and the fact I saw this gorgeous pansy online. And I'll put that on my blog so you can see that. So this one's still a little damp, but can you see the little sparkle in there? A little damp yet. We're going to wipe this off here, so let's tuck that there. And then I'm just going to set these off to the side so they can dry. Those are going to be gorgeous. All right, the little green guys. They're actually drying quite fast down here. I'm surprised. All right, so there we go. Hello, Deb. Hello, Barb. Hello, Joanne. Sorry. My, it just is not showing me the comments. I'm going to have to figure it out. There we go. So she just got home and she's catching us. Good. Good. So I hope you got to see how we painted these, and now they're drying. So now I was just showing everyone if you can see the shimmer, because we're using the shimmer paper. And you can find that on page 136. There's actually 10 sheets of the shimmer paper. So, but it's a little thicker than your regular basic white cardstock, and it just works really nice with the water, the spritzer and stuff. So I do have some already done. So let me pull those out, because this is the next part that is really fun. Okay. So what I saw online was a ruffled, and yes, a ruffled pansy, and it was gorgeous. Now, on most of the pansies that you see being done, they're done with the beard here and then the two back here. But I wanted extra layering, so for every one of these, I cut three of those. So, actually three. So what I want you to do, now they're already scored, to give them texture, but we're going to give them more. So I am just going to do like a little accordion here and go mountains and valleys and mountains and valleys. And yes, we're squishing our pansy. But when you pull this apart, look at that gorgeous dimension you get. Can you see that? It's just crazy. And look at. Oh. All right. And you do the same thing with all your pieces. I should have had some of these pre-scrunched, but it's not hard. It's just going back and forth and back and forth a little bit. And on the original design, they curled their edges, which was pretty too. But it wasn't until I saw that ruffly one online that I thought, well, why can't I do ruffles? Now, I'm not going to do this, the bottom part, and the reason being is it's going to be covered anyways. So we're just going to do the top now. All right. Our little pieces over here. Oh, they dry faster than you think. But I wasn't sure how well they would do. They actually fold like this a little nicer when they're damp, but I didn't want to have soggy cardstock making our pretty flowers. So there you go. See that beautiful, beautiful ruffle there? All right. And I'm going to have to steal one of these because I don't know where my other one dashed off to. So we're going to grab this one here. Trying to feel which one's a little drier. This one. So all three are going to get crinkled. See how much easier they're to do when they're a little damp. So you can do that with their when they're damp and then just let them sit. All right, so now we got this. So I think I'm going to use this one for the beard down here. Just because I like the way the colors go. So grab your glue. You're going to need that. And like I said, ladies, this, I have not seen anybody doing, wow, what's up with that guy? All right, let's just borrow some of that. Because we don't need that much. And we'll put that here. This is going to hold everything nicely together. I'm going to pull that up just a little bit. Look at it. It almost looks like an angel. All she needs is a head. So if Kathy's watching, Kathy made a whole Christmas tree with angels one year. It was gorgeous. All right. And then that one, because now we got our glue on those. Now, can you see this gorgeous ruffling? And how your pansy almost transforms into a real flower. It looks real. It's so pretty. And that watercolor look just makes it look like God made this. All right, I'm getting a little carried away there, but okay. It's so gorgeous. And you just watched me do that in just mere minutes. So now what you're going to need, once that's all glued, is your playing with pattern resin dots. And the reason I chose those is because they are just a little bit bigger than the die cuts. So that's why I chose that. All right. And then you're going to tuck that right in there. And I want to give it a nice push. We're going to hold it down. That's going to really help set the glue that we just put in too, right? Oh, now look at how that yellow came down here for that little beard. You can see I drew some little lines on some of those earlier, which you can do, and I'll show you how I did that. Just take the coordinating Stampin' Write marker. So here is the Blackberry Bliss, because that's what color we're using there. And you use the writing tip, and then you can just come in and do that. You don't necessarily have to if you don't want to. That is one of the techniques they did with the other ones. So you will see those little stripes in there. So if you want to add them, you can, but just play around. See if you like them. If you don't like them, don't do them. And then you can kind of do the same to the leaves, but I don't think you really have to. And what I did is I just kind of folded it in half and then kind of brought them back out like this So just kind of giving them a little tuck together so it, I don't know, it looks like a little V or a little mountain there, a little M maybe. Just again, you're creating amazing dimension. All right. And this just, that just turns out stunning every time. It just amazes me. And I just love this ruffled look. And like I said, you can do them in any color. So here's a yellow one that I did. And if you don't think that's enough shininess in there, then, you know, never fear. Wink of Stella is here, and you can add a little Stella in there. You could even bring that down a little bit and add a little extra shimmer to that if you want. So there is our little shimmering. And depending on how wide you set these will be how big you get your pansy. So they look real, don't they? I just love it. So I'm basically here, thank you, to show you how to make the pansies, although I did not let you get away without seeing the card, a card. So I used the happy birthday greeting from this pansy patch bundle. And you can find the whole suite on pages 28 and 29 of the catalog. And remember, our colors were Blackberry Bliss, a Daffodil Delight, and Old Olive. Now, I'm just going to twist this so you guys can really see how much dimension there is. This would make a beautiful, beautiful gift tag. So do you see all that? I mean, it really sits up, and it just, oh my gosh, you guys, it looks so real. It's just crazy how real this pansy looks. And I said, I just took this technique from making these little pansies that we did, oh my gosh, I think it was 11 years ago that we made these out of the butterfly punches. So I use Blackberry Bliss. You can use Gorgeous Grape. That would be gorgeous, wouldn't it? And any color. But here again, this one's got more white and less of the color. This one's got more color. And then we got our yellow one. So you could, we could actually add that one too there. Or this one even. Get out of there for now. But yeah, a little bit big, but crazy. They're crazy, amazing, look like real. Oh my gosh. So I hope this inspires you guys to try this. If you don't have the pansy petals yet, and you want to purchase it within the next few days, go on my website at lindaloves.stampinup.net and get that bundle, and I will send you a free gift. So I've got a little gifty here for anybody that gets that. And before you ladies leave for the evening, I hope you really didn't like this. Please leave your comments on how you feel this technique worked with this set. So this is just a water painting technique, watercoloring with the new pansy petals. So there we go. And I am going to now spin. We are going to spin to see who wins this silver glitter washi tape. Thank you, ladies. I'm glad you like it. I hope this technique inspires you. And now let's see who got lucky. So let's go swip over here. We're going to hit the full screen. And I will put this
video on my blog tomorrow, along with the card that you guys got to see, and then I will have another one as well. So, cross your fingers, and let's see who wins that beautiful washi tape. 3, 2, 1, go. Nicole. Congratulations, Nicole. You got silver washi tape. Woohoo! Thanks, ladies. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below, or you can message me right here on Facebook. Otherwise, you will find this video on my blog tomorrow and also on YouTube. It will be there. And all my Facebook page, my blog, and my YouTube page are all named Linda's Stampin' Escape. So kind of easy to find. Congratulations, Nicole. Thank you all. You have a wonderful evening. Enjoy this nice weather while it's here. Someone told me it's going to get hot again. So have a great evening. And thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it. Good night.